Rising Stars, and happy weekend. I hope you all are having a great day. Oh, excuse me. So, today we're going to talk about how the last thing that your team needs from you is perfection. And we're talking about this because I think as people, we have a tendency to think, I can't be a leader until I have this figured out. Or I can't be a director because I have no idea how to do all these things. And I'm just here to tell you that to completely let that go, because the last thing that your team needs from you is a perfect director and a perfect leader. What they are needing from you or wanting from you, what is going to be the best that you can give them stems from our core values at Scentsy: simplicity, authenticity, and generosity. So everything as Scentsy consultants and successful Scentsy consultants wraps back around those three core values. So whether you're an essential consultant or a superstar director, if you are authentic with your team, you are yourself to them, they are going to resonate with you and they are going to want to be in relationship with you and be drawn to you and trust you and follow you and want to remain on your team. Now, that's to say, if someone falls off of your team, that doesn't mean that you're not doing that necessarily. Life happens, things change, people change. So if you lose teammates, please don't beat yourself up. It is not your fault. This is a lesson that I learned through losing many, many teammates, right? So I know how it feels, and it hurts. If you haven't lost a teammate yet, I'm not going to say you will, because you might not, but if you do, it hurts. It's hard not to take it personally, but it isn't anything personal. So that doesn't mean that you're doing a bad job if you lose a teammate. However, for the teammates that stay, they're going to want to stay because of their relationship with you and because of they like working with you and they like that you are authentic and trustworthy. Simplicity. Same thing. It's not a complicated thing that you have to do this and this and this and this and this and this and this to make it work. And as a leader, if you make it complicated, it's going to be going away from the core values and it isn't going to be driving for your business. So keep it simple. It's basically, you know, buy, host, join, right? And just working with everybody on that. And generosity. As Scentsy, generosity is one of the core values. Contribute more than you take is something that Orville talks about constantly. And this is true of your, you know, this doesn't just mean incentives, which incentives are great. People like tangible rewards. This is, you know, being generous with your shout outs, like we talked about earlier in the week on Facebook, and text messages, being generous with your recognition, things like that. This is something that I try to get better at this year. If it pops up into my brain, I try to do it. That sounds bad. That could be bad. But think of this in the way of recognition. So if I think to myself, hey, that was really great, I will tell that person immediately, because if I wait, I might forget about it. So that's a little trick that's helped me as far as being generous with recognition. Just sharing people. Like, there's no limit on the amount of compliments you can give a month, right? It's not like, oh, you've reached your 100 compliments, so you better use those compliments up wisely because you only get 100. No, you can give as many unending compliments to people and people on your team who are doing great, and customers and things like that. There is this girl, Anik Gervais. She's a superstar director from Canada somewhere. And she was on, I don't even know, something, superstar or Zoom huddle or something like that I was on, or maybe I watched one of her trainings, something like that. I'm not sure. But she had a post-it note, just simple, which I'm like a post-it note junkie. I seriously love them, and I get so frustrated when I can't find any, like, right now. Those ones are yellow, but they're no good. Here, we'll pretend this is Great Divide Physical Therapy. I would never use that, but I just like playing post-it notes like this, but they're already written on my ones that are right here. So she had a post-it note, and it just said, make someone feel awesome today. And it was seriously like on her screen right there, like on her screen so she could see it. Make someone feel awesome today. And I absolutely love that because it is such a gift to make somebody feel awesome and make them feel good about what they're doing and make them feel like they are valued and needed, because we all are, but very little are we reminded of that or told that, right? Or made to feel that way. So, sadly. So being generous with your compliments, being generous with your time. So we know that family comes first as well in the Scentsy business. Family comes first to everybody, as it should. But maybe you have set hours where your team can contact you. And instead of saying, you know what, I don't have time to answer your question, I don't have time to talk to you about what's stressing out, I don't have time to talk to you about this, carve out some time and be generous with your time towards your team. That's what they need from you. They don't need you to be the perfect leader. They don't need you to have a program written out for how they're going to promote to each next level. They don't need you to know the FAQ memorized from the Scentsy Workstation or anything like that. So most of the time I feel like what our team needs from us is someone to turn to and someone who's authentic, simplistic, and generous, which you all are. But I want to reaffirm to you, if your insecurities that we talked about earlier in the week that are holding you back have anything to do with not being the perfect leader or not knowing how to be the perfect leader, to just know that our team doesn't need perfection. Our team needs somebody who's willing to learn, or your teams need someone who's willing to learn alongside them and support them and take them with you every step of the way. So that's our training for today, and our little snippet for today, I guess. It's just not really so much a challenge or a training, but something to think about as we go forward and as you really put on that leadership hat going forward in your Scentsy businesses.